Welcome back. So let's see. We're on problem number 15. Boy, this SAT can be tiring. I know you probably rolled your eyes when I said that because you're the one that has to take it, not me. Anyway, number 15. The graph above shows, and this is on page 399, shows Alina height in inches. So the graph looks like this. So this is, looks like, let's see, this is one, this is the other. And then I'll draw the rest. I don't have to draw these fancy lines. You get the point. So this is her age. And they do it at 6, 8, 10, and 12. And then when she's 6, she is 45 inches. This is in inches. So at 6, she's at 45. At 8, she's at 50. At 10, she's at 55. Oh no, a little less than 50. Well, this is like, on the graph, it looks like 55. And the way they draw it, it's like a little bit lower than 55. So 10, it's like a little bit lower than 55 on the graph. And then at 12, she's right at 60. So 12, she's right at 60. So 12, she's right at 60. And then they draw a line connecting all of them. So it looks something like this. So the line looks like this, like this, like this. Nothing fancy. And it says, Elena's height at age 12 was what percent greater than a height at age 6? So when she is 12, age, height. So at age 12, she's what? At age 12, she's 60 centimeters. That's this point, right? 60. And at age 6, she's what? 45 centimeters, right? Age 6, 45. 45. So this question is really, so there we got to make sure that we're reading. Elena's height at the age of 12 was what percent greater than her height at the age of 6? So they're really saying 60 is what percent greater than 45? And so I actually do this all the time in my job. I work at a hedge fund. But this is what I do all the time. And a really quick and dirty way of doing this, you would literally say that, well, this is the same thing as 60 divided by 45 minus 1 to get you the percentage. Because, well, I don't want to confuse you too much. But 60 divided by 45 would tell you what percentage 60 is of 45, right? So 60 divided by 45 is what? It's 1 po and 1 and 15 45ths, or 1.33333, right? I think you can confirm that. So that equals 1.333333. Or 60 is 133% of 45, right? So we can make all of these statements. I mean, 60 over 45, that's the percent that 60 is of 45. That's 1.33333. Keeps repeating, right? Repeating. But they want to know what percent greater than her height at age 6. So 60 is 133% of 45. This is the same thing as saying that 60 is 33% greater than 45. Hopefully you understand what I'm saying. Saying one thing is 133% of another thing is the same thing as saying that this first thing is 33% greater than 45. Or we could say that, saying something 133% is equal to 33% more than 100%, right? More than 100. Hope I'm not confusing you. But I try to do this in a couple of different ways to help you understand what 33% greater means. 33%, if x is 33% greater than y, that means x is 133% of y. So they want to know how much greater is 60 than 45? Well, it's 33% greater. 33% greater. And so the answer is C, 33 and one-third, because it's repeating 33. Next problem. Image, clear image. All right, oh, this looks fun. So we have this cylinder-looking thing. Let me see how well I can draw a cylinder. Well, my cylinder is going to be a little tilted, but you get the point. I should have drawn these vertical lines first. So this is the cylinder. So that's the cylinder. And they're saying that if we, so on the base of the cylinder, we have this line x, or this distance x goes to the center. This is essentially the center of the cylinder. And then let me draw it in a more muted color to show that it's in the inside. And then this is kind of the height of the cylinder, goes to the top. And they're essentially asking, saying which of the following, and they give you a bunch of choices, has the same volume as a cylinder shown with radius x and height 2x. So they're saying, this is x, that's x, and this is 2x. So before figuring out which of the choices has the same volume as this thing, let's figure out what the volume of this thing is. Well, the way you don't have to, if you know the area of a circle, you essentially know the volume of a cylinder. Because it's really the area of you can kind of figure out the area of this base, and then just multiply it times the height, right? Multiply it times this third dimension, the height. So what's the area of this base? So volume is equal to area of the base, which is pi times the radius squared. So that's pi x squared. And then we're going to multiply that times the height, times this, times 2x, right? Times 2x. So the volume of this is equal to 2x times this, you get 2 pi x to the third, right? Because this is x to the first, add the exponents. So volume is 2 pi x to the third. We know the volume of our cylinder. So let's see what these other choices are. So choice A says a cylinder with radius 2x and height x. So radius is equal to 2x and the height is equal to x. So what would this be? The area, the volume would be, it would be this times pi, this squared times pi times this, right? Because we take the area of the base. So the area of the base would be what? It would be pi times 2x squared, and then we multiply that times the height. And this equals, I can already tell you this isn't going to be right because we're going to get a 4 in here. And this is x, right? The height is x. So this will get 4 pi x to the third if you multiply it out. So that's not it. B. A cylinder with radius 2 pi, radius is equal to 2 pi x, and height is equal to x. And I can already tell you this is going to be it because we're going to get something with a pi squared in it, right? Because you take the area, of the base, you get the volume will just be pi times 2 pi x squared times x, right? Times x. And we're going to get 4 pi squared, and then you're going to have another pi, and 4 pi cubed. It's not going to be the same thing as this. Choice C. A cube with edge 2x. Well, this is easy. If a cube has side 2x, its volume is just that side cubed, right? So volume would be 2x to the third, and that equals 8x cubed. That's definitely not right. D. A cube with edge 2 pi x. So same thing, the volume for this cube would be 2 pi x to the third. And this is going to be what, 8 pi to the third, x to the third. Once again, not right. So assuming I haven't done anything wrong yet, it's probably going to be choice E, but let's confirm. Choice E. A rectangular solid with the dimensions. Ah, see, this looks very suspicious. So let me draw the rectangular solid. A rectangular solid with the dimensions x, 2x, and pi x. So we just multiply width times height times depth. So 2x, so it's x times 2x times pi x. You would get 2 pi x cubed. 2 pi x cubed. And the answer is E. Very good. And you could have done that faster, just kind of like inspecting some of these earlier ones. Anyway, I'll see you in the